everyone, a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. So guys, in our previous session, we have covered what is sort, filter and search functions in our NumPy arrays. In our today's session, we will be talking about four more functions. Let's have a look on what are these functions. The first function over here is shuffle. So as the name suggests over here, it shuffles the elements. Suppose if you have any array which has, let's say, 1, 2, 3, 4 elements, and if you shuffle it, you will be getting any random elements over here. So we will be randomly shuffling it. And maybe we can get 3, 2, 1, 4 or any random output we can get over here with the random elements that are shuffled here. Next is unique. The unique function is used to find the unique elements in an array. For example, if you have an array which has elements like 1, 2, 1, 3, 9, 7, 8 and 2. So in this way, you will receive an array which has unique elements. For example, you will the one over here is coming 2 times 2. In this case, it will come only one time. The 2 over here is coming 2 times. In this case, it will come only one time. 3, 9, 7 and 8 would come just like this. And the commas should not be there because these are arrays and not the lists. So I'll just remove these commas. So we will be receiving an array over here which has a unique element. That means no repeating values are allowed inside this array. Next is resize. Resize, the function is used to recreate a new array with a specified shape. So suppose if you have provided with a specified shape that you want 2 rows and 3 columns, or you want 3 rows and 2 columns. In that case, resize function is used. And lastly, we have Ravel. Ravel changes a 2-dimensional array or a multi-dimensional array. Suppose if you have a multi-dimensional array like this, you have 2, 3, and here you have 3, 4. This is one whole array. And suppose you have one more, so let's make it a 3-dimensional array. So we have 4, 8. And let's say we have 5, 6. So if we have a 3-dimensional array, what Ravel will do, it will flatten it and give us the output like 3 will come again. So 3 and no commas here. So 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 8, 5, 6. In this way, we will obtain an output over here with the 8 elements. That means it will flatten it into 1-dimensional. So let's have a look on how these functions work in a PyCharm. So to use these functions in our PyCharm, we will first import NumPy as np. Once we have imported NumPy as np, let's create an array over here. For creating an array, I will be writing arr is equals to np.array. And here we'll pass some elements in the format of a list. So I'm writing 2, 4, 6, 8, 3, 6. Okay. Now I want to randomly shuffle it. To randomly shuffle it, what I'll be doing, I'll be writing, first of all, let's print it. So I'll be printing arr. And if I run it, I'll get the output. So we are right now getting the same elements, that is 2, 4, 6, 8, 3, 6, and if I shuffle it by writing np.random.shuffle, and what do we need to shuffle? We need to shuffle arr. So now let's print arr after shuffling. So it basically does not create a new array, but it shuffles the existing array itself. So if I run it, you will notice that over here on the top we have 2, 4, 6, 8, 3, 6, which is the exact same array over here, but after shuffling we have got this output 3, 6, 8, 2, 4, 6. Every time we will shuffle it, we will get a different output. For example, 466382. Again, if I run it, I'll be getting a different output and different output. The first one will remain the same, but after shuffling, whatever the value is after shuffling, that will always change over here. This is how our shuffle works. Similarly, let's move ahead and talk about our next function, that is unique. For unique, I'll be writing arr is equals to np.array, and I'll be passing a list. 20, 50, 40, 50, 60, 50. Okay, and I want to, so you can see many of the numbers are repeating over here, and I want an array which has unique elements. That means these elements are occurring only one time. For that, what I'll be doing, first of all, let's just print it. So for printing it, I'll be writing print arr, and if I run it, I'll get the output 20, 50, 30, 20, 40, 50, 30, 20, 40, 60 and 50. After this, we need to obtain the unique value. For that, we will be writing np.uniqueArr, and let's print it. I'll be printing np.unique, and in that, I'll be passing arr. As soon as I run it, you will see that now I'm receiving only 5 elements, that is 20, 30, 40, 50, 16. All the repeating elements have been eliminated from here. This is how you can get a unique array over here. Suppose if it was multi-dimensional. In that case, if I run it, I'll be getting 20, 30, 40 and 50 in this way. So still I'll be getting a flattened array with the unique elements. This is how our unique function works. Now let's move ahead and talk about our next function, that is resize. For resize, again I'll be taking an array. For that I'll be writing arr is equals to np.array, and inside it I'll be passing a list. Or let's make it 6 elements for first. Let's just take 6 elements and I want to resize them. For resizing them I'll be writing, first of all let's print this arr. If I print it, I'll be getting an output which looks like this. Now I want to resize this and I want to resize it into a form of 2 rows and 3 columns. For that I'll be writing print np.resize. What do we need to resize? We need to resize arr, and I'll be passing in the form of a tuple 2, 3, that means 2 rows, 3 columns. And as soon as I run it, you can see over here we have received 2 rows, that is 252 and 573, and 3 columns here. And you can do the vice versa as well. You can write 3, 2. So you need to be careful about this thing, that if there are 6 elements, it can either be divided into 0, 6, that 1 or 6, that means you can have 1 row, 6 columns, or you can have 6 rows and 1 column. Or what we can do over here, we can give 3 and 2. If I would have written 4 over here, in this case, what would have happened? This first value will repeat again. So if I run it, you can see what will happen, 25, 25, 73, and again 25 is repeating. That means it will give us 4 rows, but what it will do, it will repeat the elements, because there are no elements existing inside it for 4 columns and 2 rows. So that's why it will repeat the elements and give us an output. So even if I write, let's say 4 by 4, that I want 4 rows and 4 columns, in that case what it will do, it will just write 25, 25, then 73, again 25, then 25, 73, and 25, 25. That means what it is doing, it is just repeating the elements over here. So this is how our resize works. Now let's move ahead and lastly talk about our Ravel function. For Ravel, again I'll be writing arr is equals to, and this time I'll be creating a multi-dimensional array. So np.array, and here I'll be passing a multi-dimensional array, where 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. And to flatten it, we will be using the Ravel function. For that we will be writing, first of all let's just print arr. So I'll just print arr. As soon as we run it, we will get the output as 2, 3 and 4, 5. And if I want to flatten it, for that I'll be writing print np.ravel. And what do we need to do? We need to pass arr inside it, and as soon as we run it, I'll be getting an output by 2, 3, 4, 5. Similarly, if it was 3 dimensional array, so I'll be adding just some more elements here. And 6, 7, and to make it a multi-dimensional, we will be adding one more set of square brackets here. Once we have made it multi-dimensional, that means 3-dimensional, and if I run it, you will notice that over here we have a 3-dimensional array which has like 4 rows and 2 columns, and here we have received one flattened array. So doesn't matter if it is 2-dimensional, 3-dimensional or multi-dimensional, it will give us a flattened array. What will give us a flattened array? A Ravel function will give us a flattened array. So I hope guys that all the 4 functions over here are clear to you. The shuffle allows us to shuffle all the elements inside the array. The unique function over here gives us an array which has unique values. The resize function resizes our array into the number of rows and columns that we want to resize it with. And lastly, we have Ravel function. The Ravel function allows us to flatten our multi-dimensional or 2-dimensional or 3-dimensional arrays. So I hope guys these 4 functions are clear to you. In our next session, we'll be talking about inserting and deleting the elements inside the array. So stay connected guys, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.